लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु हरिः ॐ श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ. See, the thoughts are coming, those who said thoughts are coming. Go to the inner feeling of I amness, the feeling of aliveness, I amness. So if you stay in that, the thoughts will not come. Thoughts will disturb because you are in the Chidabhasa. So you stay in the Chidabhasa, gradually Chidabhasa will merge with the pure eye.
Then it's just
sleep. It's like aware, but sleep. There's like, there's no other thought. It's not sleep you do in the night. It's like awake but sleeping. So if any thought comes, okay, don't fight with the thought. There's no need to fight with the thought. You have to just remember the thought, feeling, emotion, perception are appearing in my consciousness, awareness. So your attention is not on the thought now, it's on the awareness. I am aware of this. So become aware. Shift your attention to awareness, that's all, nothing else. So, a thought comes. Bring it to I am feeling. Again thought comes, bring it to I am feeling. So, now too many thought comes. Who am I? I am feeling. I am aware of I am feeling. I am awareness. So, like that you go back to awareness. Gently, no fighting with the thought. Just go back to I amness. It's Chidabhasa. And from there, you will gradually slip into pure eye. Don't have to do any struggle. So, all that, any thoughts come, too many thoughts come, I am aware of thoughts. Who am I? I am awareness. Just this much be gentle. Don't have to fight with the thoughts. And even if thoughts are there, remember, thoughts are like wave in an ocean. The consciousness is the ocean. So thoughts are a part of me, rising and falling. If you keep that attitude, you don't fight with the thoughts. Waves cannot be separated from the ocean. So waves are rising and falling in the ocean. I am ocean of consciousness. Like that, you have to stay. Don't have to reduce the thoughts, don't have to fight with the thoughts. Just accept the thoughts as waves in consciousness.
And the purpose of meditation is to always have that awareness, is it?
No, no. As purpose of meditation, the Chidabhasa, which is I am, okay, it associates the body, mind and intellect. It thinks I am the body, mind and intellect. It is the one who is storing the recording memory and all. Now, Chidabhasa, once it starts realizing I am pure awareness, its identification of the body, mind and intellect wash drops. So that's where you are becoming one with the Shiva. I am pure consciousness. So Shiva, the pure consciousness doesn't have to understand I am pure consciousness. The body, mind, intellect doesn't have to understand I am pure consciousness. Who has to understand it?
Chidabhasa.
Chidabhasa. Which is nothing but, again, Chidabhasa, don't confuse. It's just I am feeling in you. There's a feeling of I amness in you, right? There's a feeling of aliveness in you, no? Inside. Right? Just be aware.
Meditation helps you to find.
You are the self. There's no feeling of the self. There's a dropping of non-self. So right now you are thinking you are a body, mind, and intellect. Gently, the wave has to recognize I am the water. Water doesn't have to recognize. Water is, wave is already water. So wave is thinking that I am the shape and all. You have to remember, even this shape, I am one with the water. So what will happen? Gently, you'll feel the feeling of body and mind disappears. It's almost like a deep sleep, but fully aware. So now, your attention has gone back to the self. Others say attention is the body, mind, intellect, and the world. It's a drifting. So the more you go back to the self, it's not a new experience. It is just silence, peace. So in that silence and peace, you recognize I am infinite, I am Shivoham. So in deep sleep, you are Shiva, but you have to recognize in the waking state. Now in waking state also, you go to deep sleep-like state and recognize that I am Shiva.
So silencing me is meditation.
Again, silencing is actually a violent word.
Right? Heartless mind is...
Don't do anything. Don't use any violence. Don't use any force. Be gentle. Understand. Oh, thought has come. Don't fight with the thought. Thought is like a wave in an ocean. The wave doesn't disturb the ocean. The wave has no effect on the ocean. What is ocean? Pure awareness. I am awareness. Don't fight with the thought. Meditation is not fighting with the thought. Meditation is not suppressing thought. Meditation is not stopping thought. Meditation is understanding thought is nothing but water, awareness. So, giving another analogy, gold and gold ornaments. A necklace is there, ring is there. Oh, this is a ring, if you say, it's a thought. Oh, ring is made up of gold, it means meditation. So you have to remember your original nature, which is awareness. That's all. And then you cannot find awareness as an object. The moment you remember that, the mind becomes silent. Just that's all. No force, no fighting. Any questions?
So only that when the thoughts come, the attention switching from thought to the awareness.
No, there's two stages. No? When the thoughts come, you shift back to I amness.
Yeah. Before that, you kind of get lost in the thoughts.
Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Kind of get lost in the thoughts. You're still awareness only. So nothing has happened to you. The problem is, you start thinking that I am the body and mind intellect. So that habit you have to reduce. Again, come back. You get lost in thoughts. It doesn't matter. Come back to the awareness, to I am feeling, then awareness, stay there. See, the whole point is people are thinking that meditation is exercise, meditation is doing, meditation, I am doing something in meditation, I am fighting the thoughts. All wrong. Meditation is not at all stopping thoughts. Meditation is not at all fighting with the thoughts. Meditation is not suppressing thoughts. These are all violent languages. Meditation is just shifting your attention to awareness, I am feeling, which is Chidabhasa. So from I am feeling, you become aware of who is aware of I am, which is me. This aware of awareness. Okay, in between thoughts come and up and down, accept it. This is a part of awareness. Okay, one more hint is there. If thoughts, too much of thoughts are disturbing you, shift your attention to sensations of the body. Body has sensation. So then what will happen? The mind cannot generate thoughts and focus on sensations. It is generating sensations. In the sensations, it's easier to recognize waves. The wave is coming and going in my consciousness.
Can't we do without thinking all these things? Just sitting and...
Do it.
When I sit, I don't think about me or I. Just...
Do it. Sit silently. So the question is, can't we do? Who is we?
No.
Who is we? The whole point here is, it is not meditation. It is recognizing I am Shivoham. So if you have recognized Shivoham, meditation is not required. You are already Shiva. So even if you have recognized I am Shiva, the mind may be still going back to the old habits. So that's why you need meditation.
ತ್ಯಾಗರಾಜರ ಒಂದು ಕೃತಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಮನಸ್ಸು ಸ್ವಾಧೀನ ಮೈನ ಆ ಘನುನಿಕಿ ಮರಿ ಮಂತ್ರ ತಂತ್ರಮು ಏಲ ತನುವು ತಾನು ಸೊ ಅ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹೂ ಹಸ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ ದಟ್ ಹೀ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ವೈ ಶುಡ್ ಹೀ ಮೆಡಿಟೇಟ್
Not required. So the meditation is actually, the mind has a habit of constantly generating feeling that I am the body. ultimately the chidabhasa uses the mind only, no? So it goes back to the habit pattern. So another thought rises, memory and the body. Old record comes up. Again you come back. Anybody has a question? Jonah Chinito. Just 1 minute. Hello. How bani? Allah aur ke security handle to idkar sidro message idkar sidro namge call marte sidro. Ila ni security ke liye namge idu band bittu de code band bittu de. Security ke liye namge yau gate adri dera. Allah elder gate adri gate main gate alwa. Main gate, bani, vada bani, 7212. 7212 on the head security gate. 7212. So, what's happening is, the every experience is recorded as memory, and memory is not you, chidabhasa. It is recording the body mind as me. Is continued with illusion. So the teaching helps you to get out of the breaking of this memory habit and remember your true nature, chidabhasa, which is I. So as you do that, mind becomes very, very calm and peaceful all the time, because mind is constantly is running. Chidabhasa is allowing the mind to run. Shall we? Too heavy?
No, it's clear now.
It's clear? What about you?
It's not very heavy. It's
heavy. It's heavy. See, the world. Somewhere she doesn't like the word heavy. Okay? In silence. So the heavy word has some connotation with her body and all. So she doesn't like that. Okay, now is it tough?
The quantity is a little bit too much.
Too much.
No, it's not like it is a bit confusing. I don't know how clear with that.
It's clear. What is confusing and what is clear?
So with that chidabhasa I had confusion. Then now that's clear.
Chidabhasa is the feeling of aliveness in you. Yeah. So that is thinking that I am the body. So now that you have to understand, that guy is Shiva. So the body mind is constantly changing. What is not changing is that aliveness which is there in you, consciousness. Okay, but that is forgotten that I am coming from I. It's clear. What is it? Yes or no?
It's clear.
It's clear but not clear. What is not clear? It's clear, but what? What is that? What is that but part?
If I is same, like if everyone is the same, why do we have different personalities and all?
The personality is coming from the body mind, no? Mm-hmm. The personality is coming from the body mind, no?
It's our genes and conditioning.
That's the vehicle which is used by the consciousness. A monkey has a different genes. Donkey has different. That's a vehicle, experiencing vehicle. If I put red glasses, world look red. If I put pink glasses, world look pink. But it's me only. I only is putting different glasses. The world experience changes, no?
So it's like an entertainment for the eye. All
the it's yes. What is not clear?
It takes some time to get digested.
Okay.
Clear. What is clear means? Past, we should not remember and don't react to the past.
Who is we?
Consciousness.
So does consciousness remember anything?
No, chidabhasa remembers.
Chidabhasa has to go back to consciousness. That's not. You don't have to worry about the memories and all. Just remember your own nature.
Yeah.
Chidabhasa.
So nothing is real,
Ishu. Everything is changing, you can say.
Hmm.
Everything is a continuous change. If you take a snapshot and start thinking that as real, it's false. Snapshot is not real. Some experience happened in your life, bad experience. So now you are crying now. That situation is completely changed, that person is completely changed, your person has changed. But your only memory is there. The memory is also not real because the memory doesn't record Chidabhasa. Memory is recording only the body mind. So then for whom you are crying?
So we should forget the past and go forward.
There's no question of forgetting past also. It's irrelevant. The past is useful to the extent of for my functional use. My house is here is useful because I have to go there. But whatever lot of psychological packaging you do is irrelevant. That person, this person, they are all persons are not there. They are all changing entities.
We have to understand to live in the moment. To live in the moment.
The moment? You are living in the moment only. Okay. You are always living in the moment only. But what you are giving is, you are giving a reality to memory which is not real.
So if you think these memories are real, you will be sad always.
You are getting into depression, right? The mental problem is because you are giving, what is a person who is psychiatrically disturbed? He is always constantly going back to some memory and thinking it's real. That memory becomes reality now. But the reality has changed. This person has changed, that other situation has changed, nothing is there. You are giving reality to unreal. Right? So now, you tell him to forget the past, he can't forget. Because it's haunting him, it's very horrible. And he has to understand, what you are seeing is not real, it's an image. You are real, you are consciousness. So go back to yourself. Instead of telling you to forget the memory, tell him to go back to Shivasurupi. So then this will naturally grow because this is unreal. Don't constantly focus on what is unreal. Oh, I want to forget. That's again a problem.
Some learning would have happened from that bad experience.
That you can use now. Any learning is useful. But psychological content is we are unnecessarily adding.
So even psychiatric problems can be solved by getting Atmajnana?
But the problem is, to get Atmajnana, there are some conditions. One is that the person who has psychiatric problem should understand, I have a problem and it will solve, my problem gets solved by Atmajnana. Then he has to respect Guru. He has to follow the teaching of Guru. So it doesn't happen by magic. So he has to have faith that Atmajnana will solve my problem and Guru will help me, then it will solve. And I have seen that happening in some cases. And I have seen that's not happening in some cases because people have more faith in the psychiatrist rather than the Guru. So they are more comfortable with the medicine than the teaching.
In some other way, all of us are psychological patients and that's why we come to you because we want
actually,
to get back to reality.
Actually, psychological patients are fortunate because they know they have a problem. And they think there's a medicine. They are lucky. Whereas other people, they don't know they have a problem. They have such a problem and they are mess for themselves and others also.
They can control this.
They think they are normal. No, they think they are normal and everybody else in the world is abnormal. Psychiatric patients, they are very lucky because they know that I have a problem, I have to take medicine. Whereas other people, normal people, I am normal, everybody in the world is abnormal. What kind of situation is this? Psychiatric problems are, they treat the psychiatric patient for personality disorder. So he'll have one personality, other personality. Because it has gone to extreme case, he is not fitting in the society. Actually, he is right actually. He has understood this society. He is living properly. Whereas in society, we have multiple personality disorder. I am talking to you, immediately you have become a childhood girl. I am talking to her, she has gone to her friend. Wow! Multiple personalities. And the problem is, psychiatric patient knows I have a problem. Whereas you think Others are problem. You think that whole of the world has to be present to psychiatric problem. I am okay. Okay.
I understood,
sir. Okay. Clear? This is clear. Memory and how we are filling up the gap with memory. And this gap, what we are filling up is not real. It's snapshots. And the snapshot is not real because it's a continuous event. Right? In essence, we are living in the unreality. Clear? What is clear?
And what is the actual purpose? What is the actual purpose of memory then?
Memory is useful for transaction.
But it records everything. See, as if I
it
have
records
a
everything.
Record.
It records everything because you, as Chidabhasa consciousness, has kept the camera on. For me, I can't even remember what happened yesterday because my camera is shut off. After this class, I won't even remember how many people came, who came. I won't remember anything.
It is normal.
Huh?
It is normal.
Is that normal?
Is that normal, she is asking.
No, but I'll remember what is required.
That's selective memory.
I'll use, this is useful information, I'll remember it. Something which is like my book, no? Book I want to write a note, only take what is important notes. I don't want to fill up my whole notebook with some junk.
So brain should record only which things are needed.
That will happen as the consciousness becomes clear. Chidabhasa. Then you will be selective. Oh, this is important, I'll record it.
Things
don't even remember, it's just ghost. And your past memories, everything which has psychological contingents, erased. This cannot be done through hypnosis, it cannot be done through past life regression, it can be done only through dana. Your psychological disturbance condition gone. What is important? It'll record. Important is your functional requirement. Okay, I have to come to this house. If I forget it, I won't come to this house. Right? So those things, what is required for function, you'll remember. This class, I won't remember. Because I know the Gayatri has recorded. If Gayatri has not recorded, I'll remember. Okay, this class I have done. Because this is there, I don't remember. I remember only Gayatri is there. That much I remember.
So okay, push what part. To do with the already recorded memories?
Don't worry about that. This is what I'm trying to tell you.
Already recorded unconsciously. No?
I am telling you, this is what I'm telling you. Again, go back to yourself.
So if I go back to self, will they get deleted? No, right?
They'll become irrelevant. They'll become irrelevant. So please understand. Okay, you have a bucket full of water. One drop of ink is put in that. Okay, so now this one drop of ink, the bucket has water has become blue. So how do you remove that blueness of the water? You have to keep adding more water so that the water becomes diluted. Similarly, your memories, you have a past memories, some bad, some good. You cannot remove them. To say forget it is also not okay. I am just saying create some new beautiful memories. I am the self, Shivoham. So then whatever this, all these things have become diluted and unimportant. The most important positive memory, Shivoham, I am Shiva, I am pure consciousness, I am Brahman. Is there anything more than that possible? When you have got ultimate, why will you bother about a little bit chota small things? They become irrelevant.
This thought sounds irrelevant.
I am Shiva.
What? Doesn't fit into my personality.
So this is all called my personality, my thoughts, okay? Anyone? So, here please understand, don't try to fight with anything, not with your memories, not with your thoughts, not with your experiences. Focus on the right understanding. Oh, I'm sitting for meditation, thoughts are coming, too much, then you are focusing on thoughts. No. Focus should be, I am awareness, Shivoham. That's all. Focus should be on I am. Let the words come. then just understand thoughts are like waves in the ocean. They'll come anyway, they'll fall back into ocean. So every thought will come. Let's say this thought has the thought of cup has come. And it's coming in memory. It is coming in the awareness. It's gone. So all experiences will rise and fall in awareness. Is there an experiencer?
No.
Experiencer is a pseudo-entity created by memory. Is there a duality? A subject-object duality? Apple and I duality is there? There is no duality. Apple and I are one. When the experience is happening, experiencer and consciousness is one. It's a wave. There is no duality. But duality appears later because you are going back to a pseudo-subject. Oh, this is me, Prabhu, eating. This is you. The duality is an illusion created by memory. Now we are experiencing, right? Now I am experiencing this room. Is there a duality? This one whole experience, where I am a part of the experience is me. I cannot separate out. And it's one with the consciousness. There's no separation. Now momentarily my mind changes. Okay? Mind shifts from the experience. Oh, I am Prabhu, I am Guru, I am teaching. So duality has come. It has gone to memory. So I am Guru is also illusion. The reality is, the teaching is happening. There is no Guru. Experience is happening. There is no experiencer. Experiencer is coming because of the memory. Moment to moment, the consciousness only is experiencing itself in the form. It's like water has taken the form of ocean and wave. Nothing has happened to the water. That's happening. Narayana A alone is there. That's Brahman. If you understand this, you will not search God. You will find it difficult to miss God.
So true, sir.
You cannot miss God. I am searching for God. Where? I am looking at the fan and I am having the experience of fan. Is the fan separate from my eyes? My eyes are separate from mind. Mind is separate from consciousness. Fan is appearing in consciousness. It's like a wave appearing in consciousness. What is consciousness? Consciousness is God. The God at this moment, momentarily is appearing as fan. Appearing as. Every sight is his sight. Every sight is sound is God's name. Whatever you see is divine sight, provided you are in that moment. I am experiencing this, experience alone is there, is oneness, divine. The moment I go back to my memory, Prabhu has come into picture. But can I live without memory? Memory, falling back memory is possible, right? But only thing is I have to understand, memory is not real. The I is real. So then what will happen? The hold of memory on you starts reducing. You don't take it as a very person. Okay? So experiences, subject and object keep rising and falling in awareness. The subject called Pushpa and object called Prabhu and this world was freshly created today. Today night it will be dissolved. After this class it will be dissolved. Some another experience will come. Another Pushpa will come, another experience will come.
So any action which me has to do, so in that moment that will be just happening.
Doing.
There is a doing, but there's no doer. Okay? The doer is coming into picture. See, the doer is coming into picture. The moment it's a reaction. If there's moment, pure conscious action is there, there's no doer. So Pushpa sees somebody. Okay? So that person has spoken bad about Pushpa some time back. A reaction comes in Pushpa and you shout at him. Then the doer is there. Pushpa is there. But Pushpa is in the present moment. You are clear that person has changed. I have changed. The me has changed, he has changed. So then what is there is I only. Then there is no reaction. Then there is no doer. There is simply doing. There is simply love. So there is no doer in conscious action. There is a doer in a mechanical action. It is required also. For example, when you are driving, okay, some programming you have done, how to drive. Let it happen. So most of the things we put it on the mind and program it to do it certain way, let it happen. Okay, but unconsciously getting emotional is something you have to be careful. What happened?
But any doing
Huh?
Any doing which has to happen.
Huh.
So how do, like at that point, how do I decide? What should I do?
No, I'm saying, let's say you're driving a car, bike. Let it done. Who is driving the car?
Yeah, while I'm driving.
That's a program in you.
Whether I have to stop somewhere or keep going.
That is only when emotional content comes into picture. You have a certain... ನೀವು 721 ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಬಿಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರಪ್ಪ ಮಿಗಿಲ್ ಮಹೇಶ್ ಇದೆ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಹಾಂ ಅಂತ ಶಿಲೆ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬ್ ಅಪ್ಪಳೈನಿ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್ Memories are creating a false sense of me. That's called, it's like a whirlpool in a river. There's no identity, it's a river only. But it appears like a me, and this me is reacting to a situation. Understand? So when I act, it's consciousness. When me acts, it's reaction. So gradually you have to shift from me to I. Who is this me? Body, mind, intellect. But Chidabhasa is thinking that I am the body, mind, intellect. Chidabhasa is associating itself with the body, mind, intellect.
First
it starts with calmness. It deepens. Right? So actually see, you don't know until you reach there. Right? No, first you understand there is a false I. I am Chidabhasa. So then gradually it starts. Right now itself you don't have way of finding it. So there is a surface level I, which is Chidabhasa thinking I am body and mind. That's a deep I. I means the pure consciousness, silent and peaceful. So that's what you have to go back. So real I is found in deep silence. Now deep silence doesn't mean stopping the thoughts. Deep silence can be with the thoughts. So if you understand thoughts are nothing but consciousness, then already you are in silence. So thoughts, if you think that you are disturbing me, then you are fighting with the thoughts. So the moment you say, understand thoughts is nothing but awareness, where with awareness, then your attention is on the awareness, not on the thoughts. D deep silence doesn't mean stopping thoughts. Deep silence means understanding thought is nothing but awareness. I'll tell in another way. The gold ring is there, necklace is there, jewelry, chain is there. I want to find gold. It doesn't mean melting the ring, necklace and chain. It is recognizing gold in the necklace, ring and chain. Similarly, if the moment you recognize awareness in thoughts, feelings, emotions, you are in awareness. See, people think that meditation is stopping the thoughts. That means you have started fighting with the thoughts. Thoughts are nothing but a wave in consciousness. So, if you recognize thought is not my enemy, thought is just a wave in consciousness, then your attention goes to consciousness. You are silent. Don't stop the thoughts. Don't fight with the thoughts. Recognize the consciousness in the thoughts. Can thought exist without consciousness? So your attention will shift to consciousness. That is silence. Not fighting with thoughts. Not stopping thoughts. Okay. So, I am the pure consciousness. So being and becoming. Being means Atma. Becoming means Jiva. Okay? There is a false me which is created. This false me is never restful. It's always restless. Okay? The current situation doesn't accept. It wants something changed. Because the current situation, at this moment what you are experiencing is reality. It is not able to accept reality. You are seeing your friend. The friend has changed. You have changed. But you are not able to accept reality. Why friend is not smiling at me? So it's restless. Because it's going back to the memory. Oh, this friend is being with me for 20 years. Now the friend is not smiling at me. Are it 20 years or 200 years? The friend does change every moment. You also change every moment. So now you are consciousness, she is consciousness. You are not recognizing that. You are recognizing only body and mind, which is mask. So, the false me is restless. And this is where people want to do something. I want to achieve something. I want to achieve something. Constant achievement. Restlessness. The real me, real I, what I am, is now. Can you see this? Real I, which is me. Which is I, is always now, it doesn't require any change, it doesn't change. Me is never accepting the reality because it's living on the falsehood, memories, false. It constantly resists what is there in the moment, it constantly wants to change, not accepting what is there. Restlessness is caused by this me. This is I, what I am. So can you go back to I? You are peaceful. Now you are in me, you will never be peaceful. So where do you find the I? Between every two thoughts, between every two sensations, between every perception, it's already I. Background is already I. These are like waves which are rising in that. So now I want to stop the waves and see the ocean. Not required. Let the thoughts come, let the feeling come, let the perception come. Recognize all these are happening in consciousness, you are already there.
So those vertical lines are the thoughts, feelings and
emotions. Thoughts, feelings, emotions. Now I am never saying stop the thoughts, feelings and emotions. First learn how to give attention to the gap between thoughts, feelings and emotions. Then pure awareness is there. okay, then you will understand everything is consciousness only, everything is God only. Because thoughts, feelings, emotions cannot exist without consciousness. So then, no meditation. Whatever you see is divine. This is meaning called, this is the meaning of that. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Avashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi.
Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi.
So Purnamadaha means I, pure consciousness, Purna, fullness, infinite. Purnamidaha, this is also infinite, world. Does it look infinite for you? It looks finite because the infinite experience you are cutting back by going to memory.
Our perception is creating that.
No, see, right now you are looking at this world, right? So this experience is infinite experience. There's no cutting. It's one experience. The consciousness and world is one, non-dual. The moment I remember, I am Prabhu looking at this world, it's already cut. And the duality has come. Memory. So memory is the one which is really causing duality to appear. It's almost like saying, you saw a snake in the snake. Okay? Suddenly you got scared. Snake. Okay? Then you switch on light to see there's no snake, there's only rope. Where was the snake?
Mind.
Memory. The memory caused the snake to appear. This world is Brahman, pure consciousness only. The memory of incidents recorded is making superimposing on that. Oh, this is me, Prabhu, this is Gayatri. Like that, it's breaking. And the breaking is not real, snake is not real at all. What is real is consciousness. Existence. So that's why this is also Purna. My experience is also Purna. Purna, Purna Mudachya, Purnasya Purna Madaya. So if you remove the name and form from this experience, then what remains is Purna only, which is I. Fullness. So if you do this, then only realization is complete. Oh, I meditate, realization is not complete. I meditate, I experience the world, I am Brahman, and world is Brahman. Inside, outside, everything is divine, then it's complete realization. Otherwise it's partial. Oh, that person is sitting in samadhi for 10 days. No. Not complete. He is living in reality. With eyes open or eyes closed. One alone is there, I. That is called realization. Such a person is called Jivanmukta, enlightened one. Somebody spends a lot of time in meditation, fine. But when he comes back, he wants to go back to meditation, then realization is not complete. Because in meditation he can find peace. When he comes back, he's missing the peace. The peace in meditation, peace in experience of the world, they should be same. Because this, what you are seeing, is consciousness, Brahman, God, Shiva. Our sense organs and the mind are superimposing on that. For that, all that you will do is just go back yourself, I, again and again. Okay. So let us close for the day, let us pour our lunch. So this is next class is your last.